mercy that we feel in this place. How the Lord overshadows us. I love this place.
Amen.
Been here 51 years. And I never get tired of it.
Nope.
Amen. This is my family right here. This week, my oldest sister to rest. And I've had a relationship with her. But you know, even my relationship with her, nowhere compares to the relationship I have here.
Amen, amen.
With the people, and with the church, with the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. And what He does in our lives.
Yes.
We can be so thankful.
Yes,
amen. Amen. I'm so thankful for the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. I'm thankful for the Word of God that's being planted into our hearts and lives, teaching us to deny ungodliness and worldly lusts. Live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. I'm thankful for the work that God is doing in our lives. Amen. So we can stand before Him. Love Him. Amen. And let our hearts flow. Amen. And go out. Amen. And I can truthfully say I'm not ashamed of the gospel of peace. For it is the power of God unto salvation. Amen. Whether it be this natural body or if it be my spiritual. Amen. Praise the Lord. He is doing the work. Amen. In our lives. And before I go home, Brother Muller says, send them home. Amen. Before I'll give this testimony, my wife, prayers went out, and I'm so thankful for your prayers. And amen. And they had to do another surgery on her. And the words to me were dismal, and I kept calling Brother Marlowe. I'm like everyone else. I called Brother Marlowe too. Amen. I let him know what's going on, because I believe in this man of God right here. I believe in the prophet of God. Amen. And he kept telling him, and we kept saying, we'll just pray. Amen. And so she went through the surgery, and she's home healing right now. Amen. And I believe she'll be back in services soon. Amen. And I've already told her, I said, when you come back, it's going to be every time. Amen. Because I like having her by my side. Amen. I love my wife, and I appreciate her. Amen. Sunday night, I was here, and I knew the next day they was going to let us know somewhat, let us know concerning what they had found. And I looked to the Lord and said, Lord, you know, I want to do your work. Amen. And I take care of my home. I said, I need her to be healed. Amen. I need her to be free of this fear and all the things that come along with that dreaded word cancer. Amen. I said, Lord, do it. With all the dismal things that were being said, I said, Lord, let it be no cancer. Amen. We went in there and they told me that the preliminary reports are negative. No cancer. Thank you. I'm blessed. Amen. You want to know why? Shout the shout of praise. I'm blessed. Amen. The final reports haven't come back, but I'm going to tell you right now, it's no cancer. I promise the Lord, I'll be back out in your field working. Amen. And loosening myself up. Yes. Amen. To take care of the people of God.
Yes.
I intend to do just that. Hallelujah. You probably saw me around here a lot more this past week.
Amen.
What I've been. And I love the church and I believe in what, and I'll say, Lord and Savior. And I believe in the Holy Ghost having His way in our lives. If we're healed, it's going to be by the Holy Ghost doing the work in our lives. Raising that spirit up. Hallelujah. In our lives. Amen. So that we can walk through the valley of the shadow of death and fear no evil. Because we know He's with us. Hallelujah. He is with us. Hallelujah. Amen. His rod and staff comforts us. Amen. Every time I hear Brother Marlo speak that words of life, there's a comfort comes over me. Amen. A feeling. Amen. Of all the things of this life fading away, looking under Jesus as author and finisher of our faith. Amen. So we can go home believing and trusting Him.
Yes.
Amen. And no matter what may come,
yes.
Hallelujah, I know He is with us.
Yes.
And overshadowing us, He will keep Him at perfect peace,
yes,
whose mind is stayed upon Him because we trust in Him. We are those that believe unto the saving of our souls. Amen. Let's go forward. Let's testify. Amen. Let's fill these seats. Hallelujah. Let's lift our pastor's hands. Hallelujah. Let's give all of ourselves. And the Lord will just shake it down and run it over in our lives. We need a job. He'll give us a job. Hallelujah. We need work. He'll give us work. Praise the name of the Lord. We need finance. The Lord open doors where you know not how. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. And let me tell you, the Lord hears what we say. He literally. I'll give one more testimony before I send you home. Amen. I was sitting here one time looking out on the congregation and seeing the need, all the needs, and I said, Lord, and, Lord, I want to help, Lord. Amen. And I hate to give the world money. Amen. And I was trying to get a car at that time because I demolished mine during the meeting. Amen. And I'd paid down on one, and on it was everything I wanted. Amen. But the Lord kept saying, no. No. Well, I'd already paid the money out. My wife said, no. Amen. That was the other Lord that said, no. Amen. She didn't want that car. And so the Lord spoke to me and said, go to Brandon. And I went to Brandon. She found just what she wanted. I said, okay. Okay. I said, but what about the other car? I said, don't care. Don't want it. I said, so I had to call them and tell them I didn't want the car. Amen. They kept calling me about 20 times about the car. But I told them I didn't want it. And I said, well, is there a chance I can get my money back? No. And they said, well, I don't know. You know, we've held this car an awful long time for you. You know, and about 3 or 4 weeks later, the Lord was showing me. And I spoke in my spirit to the Lord. I said, Lord, you know that I don't like giving that money to those people. Lord, if you will have them give me that money, I'll give it to the church.
Amen.
Amen. The next morning, I got a call from them to come pick up the check.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I've heard the word back from them till then. The Lord hears our voice. He hears you and I. Amen. Don't be afraid to call out unto Him. Let yourself be known unto him, because he hears our cry. And do what you say you're going to do. Praise the name of the Lord, and he'll bless you for it. Praise the Lord. He's blessed me for it. Amen. And I believe the Lord is with us. I believe we're going to see so much victory in this place. In the days ahead, how many will reach out into it? Receive the victory in your lives. Hallelujah. Let him give you the victory. Praise the name of the Lord. God's going to do the work. Let's all stand and just give
praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Lord, for this night. Lord, we're so thankful for your spirit.
Thank you for this
day, Lord.
Thank you for
the glory of thy spirit overshadowing us and keeping us, leading us and guiding us.
Glory of the Lord.
Go with us this week, Lord. Lord, let your people have the victory that they need in their lives daily, Lord. Looking unto thee, Lord, believing on thee. And do a work, Lord. Bring us back together Tuesday night. Wednesday night and through the next week, Lord, and victory in Jesus' name. Amen.
I'd like to say a word before we leave tonight. I need to say a word to the choir before we leave. Brother Tom Colworth, we all know Brother Tom Colworth, and he's been singing in the choir for many years. And his wife, Sister Joyce, is very ill. And they have asked the choir to come over Tuesday night to their house. So I would like some choir members to please be here at the church like at 7:00 Tuesday evening, and we'll go to Brother Tom and Sister Joyce's house to have a service for them to sing. She can't talk, she has trouble with breathing, so that's our brother and that's our sister.
Yes.
And we owe that to them, I feel. So I would like some of the choir members to please be here Tuesday night at 7:00 so we can go to their house. Now, if you want to, Brother Tom said he's sure it'll be all right, and I hope she'll still fill up to it. But I would definitely like for some of the choir people to be prayed up and come Tuesday night, be here at 7, and we'll go to their house and have some singing and do whatever we can to be of help to them. Thank you.
Hey, let me just tack on to Sister Marla. I know she wears some. I want that some eliminated from the church. There's a new level, there's a new pace, there's a new face. A ball team doesn't show up with 8, they need 9. Right, Sherry Beth?
Yes, sir.
And a football is 11, isn't it? That's a team. That's a team. I want us to eliminate this sum of the choir being in practice. Some of the choir going and working together. Some of the choir. I want to eliminate some of the band. I want all the band. Tomorrow night is band practice. All the band will be here. I want to eliminate this sum. We're all. We're an all team. And God's going to bless this church. We're freeing ourselves from attitudes in this church.
Come on.
We don't believe we are the only people working for God.
Come on.
We believe the church is universal, that God has workers in the vineyard.
Come on.
But he's going to let us do our work that he's called us to do.
That's it.
And then he'll let us help others.
Right.
I don't know if you know that this church right now is letting another church have service Monday night and Friday night in our facilities.
Come on.
Right here.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
They are growing, they're building, they're getting ready to build it, they're working on it, but they are working here in our church. I don't know if you really know that Tuesday night we're here working. There's a great Holy Ghost service here Tuesday night.
Yes.
Wednesday night, it's just not midweek night. And I know everybody can't be every place, every time I know them. But I can tell you this, I love a team.
Yes.
I love a team. When I was a young man, I played all the sports I could get in. And if the Pentecostal attitude hadn't been so bad back there, I'd have got to play a lot more. But the Pentecostal attitude was sports was evil and sports was bad. And thank God I don't feel that way.
Come on.
I believe if you're a good member of the ball team, you'd certainly be a good member of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I believe that God loves his people. I believe it's a new day, it's a new time, and the cross is brighter tonight than it's ever been. Look at your neighbor and say, praise the Lord, neighbor.
Praise the Lord, neighbor.
Great Sunday.